For these simple examples here, it's very easy to check if the program stops on a given input or does not stop. What if we had an algorithm that could solve the halting problem for any computer program and any input? That would actually be immensely useful, for example, in software testing or in debugging. You would just write your code and then ask the algorithm, does this code go into an infinite loop at some time? And the algorithm would tell you if everything is okay. So, of course, there might be other errors, but at least you've eliminated one very annoying way for a program to crash. So let's assume we had such an algorithm. So we had an algorithm, and that algorithm or function is called halt. And halt is called with two arguments. One is a program, the other is the input. And of course, this here is a string, and this one over here is a string as well. And our specification will be halt solves the halting problem. Notice that we do not say how long halt has time for this. So halt can be an amazingly, amazingly complicated algorithm. It basically has unlimited resources. This algorithm can solve NP-complete problems, it can solve verse problems, we don't really care. The only thing that we care about is that halt solves the halting problem in some finite amount of time. So even in 1,000 years, 2,000 years, we don't care. As long as halt is guaranteed to solve this problem for any program and for any input, then we're satisfied. No further requirements other than that after a certain amount of time, the algorithm either says, yes, this problem stops on the input, or no. And now comes the amazing part. I can prove to you that this algorithm cannot exist. There is no algorithm, no matter how clever, how sophisticated, that can solve the halting problem. The halting problem, in other words, is known as a problem that is undecidable, by which we mean that no computer program or algorithm can reliably decide the halting problem for all possible combinations of programs and inputs. So how do we show that? You might remember from our proof of NP-completeness that considering all possible algorithms for a problem can sometimes lead to very, very messy mathematical proofs. In this case, however, the proof is actually not that difficult, so we're going to go through it together.